how do you make a delicious, easy, savory vegan breakfast that is both delicious, totally satisfying, and packed with plant-powered protein? Watch and see. So if you notice, we are using extra firm tofu. Drain it, sharpen your knife, get prepared to cook. Once you have your tofu drained, I like to press out any extra liquids in it. So I will go ahead and wrap it in a towel and then just put a weight on it. I just used my cast iron skillet and that seems to do the job. Then today I am adding some onions and some red and yellow bell pepper. And to go ahead and get started on this, I go ahead and soften these up and let them start to caramelize a little bit first because I just want them to be a little extra sweeter than normal. And then all you're going to do is crumble in your tofu. Be sure to not overcrowd your pan. So this is just half a block of tofu because this is a smaller saute pan that I'm using. But if I was to do the whole block, I definitely would do a bigger pan because you're really wanting to get a little bit of crispy pieces in there and get some nice caramelization and color. Tofu is very bland on its own, so you really have to work at developing those flavors. So once I get a nice caramelization on one side, I will just go ahead and flip it and prepare to add my seasoning. There are two essential seasonings, in my opinion, to a tofu scramble, and that is garlic powder and nutritional yeast. You could honestly just do just the tofu sauteed with a little bit of olive oil, the nutritional yeast and the garlic powder and a little bit of salt, and that be enough. But I really like the extra nutrients that the onions and bell pepper adds, as well as the extra flavor. The way that I like to serve this tofu scramble for the babies is I will just do a little bit of steamed rice and I add a little bit of soy sauce to the rice just for some flavor there. Top it with the tofu scramble, and this is kind of a strange part, but I add in a little bit of almond milk, and what this is going to do is kind of cool down the tofu, but it's also going to give it more of that creamy kind of undercooked scrambled egg or soft scrambled egg vibe. So it seems kind of strange, but the almond milk adds a little bit of sweetness and it also makes the tofu a little bit creamier versus the kind of chewier, more hard cooked scrambled egg consistency. For myself, I went ahead and served up some of the steamed rice as well, the tofu scramble, some greens. This is just some wilted spinach. Gotta find ways to get your greens in. And then I topped all of this with some salsa, and this made a delicious, savory, vegan breakfast.
So now that we have made the tofu scramble, I kind of wanted to talk nutrition with you guys for a minute. So to give you a better understanding of why eating plant-based is so nutritionally beneficial to your body, I like to do a comparison of what you would be eating using animal products versus the plant-based product. So our comparison today is obviously eggs to tofu. And the way I break this down is I actually just go into MyFitnessPal and I will try to get the portions as similar as possible. And then once the portions are as similar as possible, then I just go into the nutrient list on, it's like an actual breakdown on MyFitnessPal. And then I'm going to be comparing those side by side. We're not going to get into every bit of nutrition on them, but we're going to cover some of the basic groups, nutrition groups. All right, so the first thing that we're gonna be looking at are the calories. So for our breakdown today, 3 whole eggs was the serving for the eggs, and then it was a half a block of tofu, which ends up being 7.5 ounces roughly, okay? So the total calories for 3 whole eggs are 205 calories, and the total calories for 7.5 ounces of tofu is 175 calories. So we have an extra ounce and a half for total volume with the tofu, but we actually have 20 calories less. So this is the biggest takeaway I feel like from eating plant-based. You are getting more volume for less calories. So this is a great way of eating for people that struggle with weight gain, or you struggle with getting in proper nutrients like your vitamins and your minerals, because plants are packed with water and fiber and vitamins and minerals. That's like the main substance to them. They also have protein as well, but the main density to them is going to be fiber and water. And because of this, when you eat them, they actually make your stomach fuller. So it gives you that feeling of satiation. So you can eat like 2 ounces of chicken, or you can have like a huge, like 3 or 4 cups of broccoli, and you can just obviously tell this has more volume, so it's gonna fill up your stomach more and you're gonna feel more full. So calorie for calorie, eating plant-based, you get much more volume of food versus eating any kind of animal products, being meat or dairy or eggs. The next thing that we're gonna be comparing is protein. Now, this is a very misunderstood idea when it comes to eating vegan, vegetarian, plant-based, pescatarian, flexitarian, anything that does not revolve around the center of your plate being an animal product. A lot of people have this fear of, how do I get enough protein? You would be really surprised at the actual amount of protein that your body needs. So there's so much information out there, and honestly, there's too much to actually like read through and digest, but my biggest recommendation is like just trying and seeing what works for your body. Here is the protein comparison for eggs to our tofu. 17 grams of protein in our 3 eggs, and we have 20 grams of protein in our tofu. And keep this in mind too, with eating plant-based, now, soy products do actually contain all 9 amino acids, okay? So this tofu is a complete protein, just like meat. Meat is a complete protein, meaning all of those amino acids are there. But the proteins that are actually in vegetables and in carbs and everything like that, they're not complete proteins. But as long as you're eating like beans and pasta, or like broccoli and pasta, or broccoli and beans, those combinations will complete the 9 amino acids that are essential to making a complete protein. So as long as you're eating a balanced diet, and this is very crucial, a lot of people will go vegan or go plant-based and they'll just be eating like junk food, honestly, and they think it's better, but it's really not. You really still have to be eating from all the different food groups, and that's how you create that balance and that sustainability and that long-term health benefits that you get from eating a plant-based diet. Let's also just talk about the idea of how soy products can potentially increase your estrogen levels and potentially cause cancer in women, man boobs in men. Like, this is an insane idea as well. So plants do naturally contain an estrogen, but it's a phytoestrogen. It is a plant estrogen. It is not a human estrogen, similar in composition to what we create in our bodies. So if you are eating a lot of soy products and you take an estrogen test, you may show that you have higher levels of estrogen, but that's total estrogen. That's not the estrogen that creates hormonal function within your body. So there's a guy on YouTube, and I will link his I'll link his channel below, or actually I'll link the video that I watched below. It was very interesting. I actually just watched this yesterday right before doing this, so I wanted to include this as well. But his name is Brian Turner, and what he did, he's a vegan bodybuilder athlete, and what he did was he, for like 30 days, 28 days or 30 days, he actually ate over 1 pound of soy products every day. And then on top of that was also drinking like soy milk. So he was like bulking on all the soy products. And before doing all of his testing, or before doing this food experiment, he went ahead and had his blood work done and tested his testosterone levels, and then went the full 30 days and then had his testosterone levels tested again. And his testosterone levels were actually higher at the end of the 30 days. Not saying that soy products increase his testosterone levels, but they didn't affect them. So he could have just been more vigorously active during those 30 days and that could have increased it. But your testosterone levels for a male will fluctuate more, I guess for a female too, I don't really know, but they do fluctuate. So they were just on the higher end when he had them tested again, but obviously they didn't lower, which is a huge deal when you're eating over 1 pound of soy products every day. So I don't know. It's a very controversial subject. I will say with that though, I would be sure to make sure that I am picking a good quality of soy when I am getting soy, and the less processed the better. So like tempeh would be a better version over tofu. And then if you are getting tofu, I would make sure it's non-GMO, or any soy, I would make sure that it is non-GMO. So the next thing, which I'm sure everybody is interested in knowing, are carbs. For our 3 eggs, there was 1 carb, and for our 7 ounces of tofu, it was 5 carbs. Don't really know why we get so hung up on this. The World Health Organization, as well as the American Center of Diabetes, they both have put out articles saying that an increase in calories are an increased risk of diabetes, not an increase in carbs, not an increase in sugar. Being obese or being overweight increases your chance of diabetes, no matter what your diet is. And then to break it down more specifically, yeah, sugar, processed sugar and processed things can spike those levels, but that's not what's causing the damage initially anyways. Anyway, moving on. So the eggs have 1 gram of sugar. The tofu has no sugar. The fat for the whole eggs, now we're talking about soluble fat, so this would be the good fat. So the eggs have 14 grams, and for the tofu we have 10 grams. And this is where it gets a little crazy. Saturated fat, actually this isn't that crazy yet. Saturated fat for the eggs is 4 grams, and saturated fat for the tofu is 0. This would be the fat that would stay solid at room temperature. This would be your bad fat. This is the fat that you don't want. And then this is where I have been like, my mind has been transformed, and I am completely and will never go back to the idea that animal products are good for you. And this is exactly why. Cholesterol in the eggs is, for 3 whole eggs, is 492 milligrams, and then cholesterol in tofu is 0. The number one cause of death in the United States is cardiovascular disease, and the leading cause of cardiovascular disease is cholesterol. Obviously some genetics can play a role. The amount of genetics that play a role in heart disease is so minimal compared to the damage that we're doing to our bodies every day by ingesting so much cholesterol. So anyway, that's if you can take cholesterol out of your diet and ultimately reduce your risk of any kind of cardiovascular disease, that's a huge thing. Also, eating a whole foods plant-based diet is the only diet that can actually reverse cardiovascular disease. So if this is a diet that can actually reverse a disease, I mean, there's a good amount of reputability there. I'm just saying. Okay. So we got past the cholesterol, and then the last thing I wanted to look at was iron. The iron in the 3 eggs was 2% of the recommended daily intake, and the iron in the tofu was 20% of the recommended daily intake. So my biggest takeaway from this is I got almost two ounces more of food for 20 calories less, and I got no cholesterol. Also, I got more protein. It's crazy that there's more protein in the tofu scramble than in eggs, and eggs are thought of as like a high protein food. So I don't know, I definitely am not coming on here to advocate for eating tofu every morning, but if you're the person that's really just struggling with breakfast options and you've recently gone plant-based, vegan, vegetarian, whatever, I guess vegetarians eat eggs, but whatever, if you're trying to eliminate cholesterol in your diet overall and you're trying to eliminate a lot of fats out of your diet as well, tofu scramble was a great success. I won't be eating it every single morning, but it was delicious. I just feel like when you eat plant-based, you become more creative. You're trying to replicate a flavor, but in doing that, you're adding so much more nutrients. It's crazy. You would just be so surprised at how much you like eating plant-based and how creative you get, and yeah, how successful it is, because you're increasing your vitamins, you're increasing your minerals, you're increasing your phytonutrients, you're decreasing your cholesterol, you're decreasing your saturated fats, and you might not be getting the same amount of protein, but just watch, because you're not gonna like shrivel up and be nothing. We do not have a protein deficiency in America. Like, that is not a thing. You'd be really surprised. Now that I am plant-powered and I have all this nutrients, I'm gonna go do a workout and yeah, see you on the other side.
These days my windows are all tinted by the dust. My legs start corroding, breaking from all of the rust. My choir back home preaching good song we do trust. I pray that this vision help me digging through it. And we can be fair and get a little higher. You can see I'm a little more inspired. With the last drop I came a little sooner. Karma fools you, man, karma rules you. Pick and choose, that's the common rules. You're waiting for another day to stumble in some views. Catch yourself falling, you'll be walking light as shoes. Silver from your tongue, hope you touch it, speak the truth. And when I introduce the remedy, introduce the rest of me. All people here just want a piece of me. This one treat me gently, this one get the best of me. All evil around me when I try to go to sleep. We can be fair and get a little higher. You can see I'm a little more inspired. With the last drop, I came a little sooner. Karma fools you, man, karma rules you. They will find out how to lose. Why they always acting like they're carrying the truth. I'll be over here just sipping on my juice. And when I introduce the remedy, introduce the rest of me. All people here just want a piece of me. This one treat me gently, this one get the best of me. All evil around me when I try to go to sleep. We can be real and get a little higher. You can see I'm a little more inspired. With the last drop, I came a little sooner. Karma fools you, man, karma rules you. Lost it in the sauce, way of finding me.
Get your shoes on, Emmy, we gotta go. This is constant. Whenever you guys see me posting videos and they're at home videos and you're like, oh, she's got her life together. No, behind the scenes, this is what happens every time. Rego. So I was on, I just finished round 7, so I have 3 more rounds to do and I guess I'm just gonna do them at home because this is not working, so. All right, ready? All right, Lila wants her tooth pulled out.
It's this tooth here.
It's this one right here, right?
What's that?
Can't hear nothing.
Got it. Let me see.
Open your mouth. Did it hurt? It hurt?
Uh-huh.
Seriously?
Not that bad.
Let me see. Open. Let me get up close. Oh, that's so gross.
Mama! Mama!
Are you glad
cool,
it's gone?
Cool.
Now you have no bottom teeth at all. Just smile. Go like
there's blood all in the inside of it.
Yeah, that's
I can't wait to show. After I'm done FaceTiming you, I'm gonna FaceTime Gammy. Because we have it in this big Ziploc bag. I don't know why, but we just have it in a big one instead of my get one of Gammy's cigarette bags.
Oh, I gotcha. Well, I guess we gotta send the tooth via email.
No, we don't email.
They don't email?
No, she has a magic mirror.
Okay, so you're staying at Gammy's tonight. Is your Tooth Fairy gonna be able to come there?
Yeah, because Tooth Fairies have these magic mirrors that track kids that have tooths that get gone because they come and have to take the tooth. So how else would they track the kids if they, even if they didn't have magic mirrors, they wouldn't know where the kids lived.
Oh, so...
So they have to be able to track the kids from where they were before and where they go. So this is the tooth that I'm going to be doing at that place. So I'm
at where? Oh, at Gammy's?
At my Gammy's. We'll stay the night there tonight. It's the next day after tomorrow. It's Sunday Funday, so tomorrow I can't wait to see what I get, because that is what I'm going to get, because the tooth fairy will take the tooth from the Ziploc baggie. She'll take the Ziploc bag and give me something yum. I mean, not yum, but something to help me brush my teeth and do that.
Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope this was informative and understanding for you guys. I hope you will go... Hold on. I hope you'll try having a tofu scramble. You can really make it whatever you want it to be. The two main things I would say to always have would be the nutritional yeast and the garlic powder and the salt. Three things, sorry. Nutritional yeast, garlic powder, and salt. Other than that, you can create whatever. If you follow me on Instagram, yesterday morning I actually had the other half of my tofu block left, so I actually added in tomatoes, and that was great. Another great idea would be adding in like black beans or any kind of beans as well. You could add in some greens, wilt in some spinach. This honestly is pretty endless. You could almost think of this as like the ground beef of the vegan world. If that makes any sense, even though I'm using it as eggs. I don't know. But anyway, thank you again for watching. Make sure to subscribe. Make sure you hit the bell. The bell is going to tell you when I'm uploading another video, which hopefully is next Wednesday. I've been doing pretty good. But yeah, let's hope I can stay on schedule. So we'll see you guys next time.